Welcome to the series on Azure Migrate, your free migration and modernization platform, which helps you move workloads in a consistent and secure manner to Azure. In this video, we will see how to plan migration or modernization of your multi-tiered applications to Azure with Azure Migrate. The application awareness capability allows you to check for readiness to migrate to right-sized Azure targets, along with tools to use. Let's first look at the plan phase. With Azure Migrate, you can discover different workloads, such as ASP.NET Web Apps, SQL Server, Windows Server, Linux Server, and more. The new application assessment capability is designed to provide a thorough understanding of readiness and blockers for migration or modernization of workloads comprising your application. Ideal migration strategy, whether it be rehost or replatform, based on your specific migration intent or preference. Recommendations for the target Azure service, right size SKU, estimated cost, and the reasoning behind these recommendations. Migration guidance, outlining the steps you need to take to migrate or modernize your application using the recommended approach. Before you assess and effectively plan migration of your multi-tiered applications to Azure, you must ensure that all prerequisites for the successful discovery of workloads comprising the applications are met and all discovery issues highlighted in Action Center are resolved. To learn more about the prerequisites, visit aka.ms/azuremigrate/discovery. And to create minimum privileged credentials to discover workloads, visit aka.ms/azuremigrate/discovery-privileges. It is also recommended that you create a business case to identify ROI for migration or modernization, depending on your intent. Once discovery is successfully completed, you can navigate to the All Inventory blade to group workloads into applications using tags, as covered in a previous video. The All Inventory view helps you identify the infra, web, and data tiers of your applications, covering Windows, Linux, and SQL servers, as well as installed software. Let's focus on Parts Unlimited, an application that we intend to analyze and migrate. Through the new experience, we can identify workloads that power the application. We can see that it is a two-tier app, with the web tier based on .NET and the data tier based on SQL Server. We can now assess this application using two approaches. We can create an assessment by selecting these workloads and clicking Create Assessment, or grouping the workloads using tags, and then creating an assessment scope to the tag. For the purpose of this demo, we will do the latter, so we will now group the workloads together using the new tagging feature such that the key is application and the value is parts unlimited. Once you have tagged workloads into applications, you can go to Assessments view and select Create Assessment. For the case of Parts Unlimited, we will simply filter by the tag application is equal to Parts Unlimited to list the workloads. As you create an assessment, you can select the region in which you want to deploy the application, the environment of the application, and the desired offer or plan, pay-as-you-go or enterprise agreement, etc. Additionally, you can modify workload-specific advanced settings, such as preferred PaaS services for your web tier. Having selected the desired settings, we will now proceed to create the assessment. The application assessment provides you recommendations based on your migration preference. In this case, our preference is to modernize, as that approach accrues substantial savings. Here, it is evident that we can easily replatform the workloads comprising the application. Azure Migrate automatically recommends the best possible target services for the workloads comprising your application. Here, Azure Migrate is recommending us to replatform the data tier to Azure SQL Managed Instance and the web tier to Azure Kubernetes Service. Going deeper, we can see the SKU and cost details for the respective workloads, as well as the recommended migration tooling. Next, we can even identify details of what would it take to make this SQL Server ready to migrate to other target services. In this case, presence of a service broker is impacting the readiness of this SQL Server for migration to Azure SQL DB. We can do the same analysis for the web tier of the application that we can identify the readiness SKU and cost details, as well as identify the next steps to migrate the web app to Azure Kubernetes Service using Web App Migration Tool. At any time, you can modify your preference, and Azure Migrate will recommend the appropriate strategy for each workload powering the application. So if you are pressed for time, you can update the preference to minimize migration time. And as you can see now, Azure Migrate recommends a lift and shift strategy over a modernization strategy for the workloads powering the application. You can also create an application assessment covering all application in your data center by simply selecting all workloads from the All Inventory view and selecting Create Assessment. After the planning phase comes the execute phase. Once discovery and assessment are completed and you have built a high-confidence migration plan, you can leverage Azure Data Studio, Azure Database Migration Service, DMS, and SQL Server Migration Assistant to modernize the data tier of your applications. You can also leverage the Azure Migrate Containerization Toolkit, App Service Migration Assistant, and Azure Migrate Application and Code Assessment Tool to modernize the web tier of your applications. Finally, you can use Azure Migrate's server migration capability to lift and shift your servers to Azure Virtual Machines. Thank you for watching this video.